afternoon, everybody. February 20th, 2018, in a very wet, rainy day in the city of Fitchburg.
Rainy.
Welcome back
to Tuesday.
Fitchburg.
Hi, welcome.
Hi.
Talking Fitchburg.
It is.
Talking.
Imagine if
wetness.
This was a. A snowstorm.
Like, oh, Jiminy Christmas.
And this just
I don't want to
keeps
think about
going
it.
And going and going.
Just like, Energizer. That's what it is.
Mm-hmm.
Not a sponsor of the show.
Nope. couldn't afford that.
But do you remember that little rabbit?
I do.
Is he still in the commercials?
Yeah, I think there's been commercials.
Fabulous.
I thought there was like a whole bunch of battery companies just came together now.
Oh,
so
no.
It's like one big battery.
Oh, my gosh. The great battery merger of 2018. We'll be talking about it at the end of the year. I know it. Get ready, folks.
And the recap show when it comes back.
Yeah, that's right.
Remember the battery merger? Yeah.
Well, anyway, shout out to that rabbit. He was pretty cool.
He was pretty cool. And he's probably floating away right now. Or his batteries are fried.
I'll tell you. I'm not enjoying this weather.
So when I left, I pulled out of the garage. I'm lucky enough to have the garage. So I pull out. And I stop, and Lily's in the back of the truck, you know, in his car seat, and she's looking
strapped
out.
Strapped in, very safe.
Very
fully
safe
secured.
And I look out, and I'm looking on the driveway, and I think I see Sleet, and I'm like, oh, man.
Ooh, I caramba.
So, yeah, until I got, to Middleton, from there to my house it was just Sleet.
As slick as could be.
But the temperature, so it was 32. By the time I got on this side of town, it was, 35.
It's a real shame. I gotta tell you, I didn't enjoy the weather. Yesterday I was in the mood to get out there, get moving. You know what I mean? I was like, I could do some exercise today, ladies and gentlemen. But then, old father weather, you know
just,
him.
That just
he was
took
like,
it
not
away for
today.
You.
It's raining. It's unpleasant out there.
It was a deal breaker.
It was horrible, yep. And then the dog, of course, track mud all over the house. It was a great day.
Yeah, actually I was surprised. Eva usually runs out and runs back in. She just took her time. She's like, I just hate this, so I'm just going
to
let it happen.
It, ladies and gentlemen.
Nobody does like it.
Just tape a nice picture of a sunset up on your desk today, you know what I mean? Enjoy that.
But we do have some sunshine in our newscast to talk about today.
Boom!
Yeah.
Forgot we were doing a show.
Erica Klutmeyer stopping by. And guess what, Preston?
What?
We also have some unfortunate news.
No. Jeremy. Come on.
I'll save it till Erica gets on the show, but we have a special surprise for Erica, too, today.
Okay.
We're looking forward to sharing that with her, along with her sharing about the solar project. We're going to get to look at some numbers today.
I'm excited
about that.
See
how those panels
are
working. Probably not the best day to look at it, but, you know, we'll get the idea.
Get the wheels turning, thinking about that sun again.
Mm-hmm. So we've got that. We've got Jeff Doslick stopping in today. They won the biggest award you can win here in Dane County for Dane County EMS.
What did we do to just get such a wonderful lineup of guests today? What did we do?
I had to, know, I didn't even have to search. They were coming to me. Was that
got a little karma banked up. We're ready to go.
Yeah, and then weather. The rest of the day is just weather. And let's kick it off with weather, Preston. And
let's do it.
We've got a lot of messiness going around here in the city of Fitchburg. So take a look at graphics first here. You've got the flood warning. I almost said it again. Flood warning going on right now. And as I see it and as you see it, I would say there's a chunk of Fitchburg in this.
There's a little chunk maybe if you're on the south side here.
Yeah. So, and I think this graphic had some water totals as well, or precipitation.
Oh, yeah. Looking like about an inch to potentially inch and a half in the Dane County area here. Yeah.
I've got an updated one, Andrew, on my laptop. We can call it out now.
Okay.
Andrew. Hey, Andrew. Where are you?
Wow.
Hey,
look at that magic.
Yeah, so this is as of noon from observation headquarters, wherever that is, National Weather Service, Milwaukee Sullivan, maybe.
Yep.
So they're kind of showing you where those heavy rains are, and we just got plummeted right before we went on air here. We were getting it.
I heard it.
You heard it?
Mm-hmm.
You heard it big time. Your update as it stands right now, remember you got to check back frequently, because these things change pretty frequently. Indeed. And see if you click on, actually, I've got to look at my scripts. Are you even have the scripts?
Here's a script for you, Jeremy.
It says here that this flash flood or the flood warning I just want to say it always flash. And yeah, Southern Dane County is included in this. Goes till 6:45 tonight. 1 to 2 inches have fallen already. And this just counts, by the way, when we're looking at those observations. Mm-hmm. That was just for today.
Right.
So this, as far as storm totals go, this is a lot. There's a lot
clouds
out there.
Clouds up there just dropping it like it's hot.
Clouds out there.
And by it, I mean rain. Yeah.
And wow. Then your commute. Now, I've got a live look here at your commute as it stands with our friends from DOT 511.
What's up? Look at all that green.
Yeah. Looks like good winter driving is what green represents. But as far or as close as Portage, things start to get a little dicey.
A little dipey, too.
Dipey, dicey. It goes right in with rainy and wet and sloshy, any of those. Yeah.
Those nasty terms. Mm-hmm. All right. Looking good in this area, though.
Yeah. And I should say as well, I talked to our Public Works Department, and they said, yes, there's flooding in low-lying areas, and they do have some water signs out there. So keep that in mind as you're passing through the city here, wherever you're going to, that, yeah, if you see some high water across the road, what do you do?
Turn around.
Don't drown.
That's right.
It's easy as that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Today is a day for you to vote. So bring your umbrellas out there, though, when you're going. Just a reminder.
We've enjoyed the runners.
They've been running from the parking lot into the building today. Polling locations, they opened up at 7 a.m. this morning. They're closed at 8 p.m. This evening. And right here, we're just going to show you the four voting districts in your locations where you can vote in the city of Fitchburg. So Marketplace Fire Station, that's the new fire station. District number 2 at Fire Station number 1 on Lacey Road.
Don't get that confused.
Do not. And then District number 3, the Wyndham Garden Hotel.
That's new.
And District number 4, Fitchburg Community Center, right here next to us. So there you go. That is your voting locations. Make sure you get out there and cast a ballot today.
Yeah, polls are open till 8.
Indeed.
Plenty of time to get there.
Indeed.
All right, I said off the top of the show, Fitchrona EMS receiving an award, and here is that reward. They are the recipient of the Robert L. Bruning Award. Pretty cool indeed. Awarded annually to a one Dane County EMS member, and Fitchrona EMS being one of those members. The award was established in 1995 after Bob's passing to honor agencies and individuals who display and drive commitment that Bob provided to Dane County.
Yeah, it's awesome.
And Bob was a EMS coordinator.
Yeah, the first Dane County EMS coordinator. That's awesome.
So we actually have Jeff Doslick stopping in. We'll tell you all about that award coming up here in just a little bit of time.
Yep, just a few minutes away. Mm-hmm. Hey. Just got to tell you about something, though. Skate party.
It's a bad time to talk about this, but I threw it in anyway.
Yeah, so there's a note at the end here that we'll touch on. But this Saturday, February 24th, weather permitting, I'll say.
Say what?
You can join the Fitchburg Optimist Club for a skate party at McKee Farms Park. They're going to open up the warming house from 1 to 3 p.m. They're going to have games, all kinds of fun stuff going on. But again, note here, they're keeping an eye on the weather, so they see what's going on here. And they're going to update if they have to cancel due to the ice conditions. So we'll try to also let you know if they have to reschedule or cancel that event.
I feel like every year they have to cancel, like reschedule one of them.
It's that unpredictable weather. Mm-hmm. You never know.
There was some 60s around this time last year, if I remember right. So yeah, I know, right? Sounds pretty good on a day like this. All right, sticking with some weather yet again, your storm spotting classes are out there. They're coming to town. We've got two of them to tell you about. A list of what these classes include. Well, they have meteorologists from National Weather Service conducting these. You are not required to be a spotter to attend the class. They want you to learn about this stuff, right? So the first hour class is severe weather safety training presentation. The second hour will have the spotter training class, which covers that what spotters need to know to identify storm features and how to report them. The class is free, but it fills up fast. You got to register for this. And there's only two classes right now that I know of here in Dane County. And one is on March 19th from 1 to 3 p.m. And the other is also on the 19th from 6:30 to 8:30 p.m.
Yep.
Both of those at the Alliant Energy Center, Madison.
And I'm going to challenge, actually, a quick point. There is no need to pre-register, Jeremy, for these classes.
My bad.
So just if you got to show up, hey, you forget, No problem. You can just show right up. And there's a look at the times that both of those classes are for you.
Hey, thanks for covering me.
No problem.
All right, that's your headlines on, again, this rainy day. Can we say just enough? Rain.
Rain.
Rain and wet day. Coming up next, we're going to cheer up your day with Jeff Doslick, Fitchrona EMS, talking about that awesome award. That's next right here on Talking Fitchburg.